friends, we have entered into the great and terrible day of the Lord, the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Great if you're on God's side, not so good if you're not. The Lord has begun the separation, the wheat from the tares, the sheep from the goats, the angels from the demons, and heaven and hell. And this is what the Lord, there's no more greatness. You cannot serve two masters. Jesus said, if you're on the fence or if you're lukewarm, he will spew you a vomit. It's time to get on fire for the Lord Jesus, my friends. You've got to discern what time it is. The Lord's blowing a trumpet in this hour. And if you can't prophetically discern and interpret and hear that trumpet, how are you going to hear the trumpet in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16? For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, with the trumpet of God. Joel says, blow the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm in my holy mountain. Before I continue, I am a minister of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. I need your help. Please subscribe to my ministry channel. Hit the like button. Do not hit the dislike button. A thumbs down. I'll find you. I'll have to pray for you. Comment. Any videos over 6 minutes, share and watch. But the Lord did visit me about a week ago. And we should never use encounters to establish doctrine. We should only use scripture to establish doctrine. But the Holy Spirit spoke to me. He impressed upon me. I heard the voice of the Lord. He said, Rob, what's in this book that David Wilkerson wrote in 1973 is a lot closer to coming to manifestation on the earth in fullness a lot sooner than you think. Now, in this book talks about the legalization of marijuana, many other things that have already transpired. But friends, he's talking about New York City being burned to the ground, laced and wasted. And the protesters right now, due to the race riots of the murder and killing of Mr. George Floyd, they're saying we're glad gasoline is cheap. Now, I live in New York. I'm about 45 minutes from Manhattan. So I'm telling you, we are really seeing Matthew 24 unfold at a great acceleration before our eyes. Jesus said nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom. That word nation in the Greek is ethnic groups against ethnic groups. He said, when you hear of wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes in diverse places, you know it's at the door. That means simultaneously when you see more earthquakes and wars taking place daily than at any other time in the history of man, you know the Lord is coming, or the rapture, or the catching of the church. And verse 17, 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 7, then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. That's the rapture, the great catching, or the caught up means rapture and God taking the church. You do not want to be here for this tribulation, friends. You do not want to miss the rapture. Trust me, and they call it the Great Tribulation. I don't know what's so great about it, but this is 7 years, whether you're pre-trib, mid-trib, or post-trib. I'm just ready. You know, I'm not here to argue your doctrine, but I'm telling you, we are entering into perilous times. The great and terrible, the birth pangs are intensifying. The contractions are getting closer and closer. And there's things that are going to transpire on the earth. Now, I also do feel we're going to go into a great move of God and a great harvest. So simultaneously, it's the best of times and the worst of times. Anything great can happen. Anything terrible can happen. And the most important thing is, are you rapture ready? If the rapture would have come, would you go up and meet the Lord? And you don't want to sell your birthright for a bowl of porridge in this hour. So number one, if you're lukewarm, cold, backslidden, walking half-heartedly with the Lord, it's time to get radical and on fire for Jesus, my friends. And if you're not born again, Christ comes by invitation only. God will never make you serve him. God didn't create robots. The most moral person under the sound of my voice cannot and will not make heaven their home. You cannot earn salvation. It's a gift. The gift's only a gift unless it's free. If someone gives you a gift and says, you got to give me $5 a week for 5 years, that's not a gift. Christ paid our sin debt in full, but you have to respond. And certainly no one here has found the fountain of youth. No one's immortal. We're all going to die, friends. And when you take your last breath, either the elevator goes up to life insurance or it goes down to the basement. That's fire insurance, a place Jesus taught about in the Bible called hell. Now, I'm giving you an altar call. Please respond. If you confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that God raised Christ from the dead, you shall be saved. Be saved from eternal separation from God in a place where there's demons and fire, not for a billion, forever, man, for eternity. Say Jesus now. It's not reciting a prayer. It's the faith behind it that triggers and activates Christ to come reside and live in you. Say, Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Thank you for being my Lord and Savior. And friends, thank you for watching this show. Please subscribe to my ministry channel. I want to reach a generation for Jesus Christ. Watch the videos over 6 minutes. Share them with people so they can be discipled properly and trained. I've got many videos via YouTube. The Lord loves you. Be blessed.